ISLM model. Introduction to ISLM model. So starting from the meaning of ISLM, IS here stands for IS investment, S stands for saving. So basically investment and saving, this IS curve is used for goods market equilibrium. Goods market equilibrium, this curve shows goods market equilibrium. This curve shows relation between rate of interest and income limits, where investment is equal to save. So if we plot this curve, rate of interest on y-axis, income limit on x-axis, we will get the negatively sloping, downward sloping IS curve, which shows that there is a negative relation between rate of interest and level of income. Coming towards LM, L stands for liquidity preference. Liquidity preference, that is demand for money, and S stands for supply of money. And this LM curve is used for presenting money market equilibrium. Money market equilibrium, where demand for money is equal to supply of money. And this curve also shows the relation between rate of interest and income limit, where demand for money is equal to supply of money. Now by plotting this curve, rate of interest on y-axis and income limit on x-axis, we'll get upward sloping LM curve, which shows the positive relation between rate of interest and income limit. Now when both these markets, IS LM curve in both the markets, so when both these markets, goods market and money market, are simultaneously in equilibrium, that is the point of general equilibrium. When both these markets are simultaneously in equilibrium, that shows the point of general equilibrium. That means when there exists a single pair of rate of interest and income level, that shows general equilibrium point, and both these markets are simultaneously in equilibrium. Here the question arises, what is the linkage between these two markets, goods market and money market? Now this linkage starts from Keynesian